Hello everyone, it's Mike Blackburn here. I've just published the Canterbury Construction Report for September and thought I'd give you all an update on what's happening in the market. Firstly, my apologies. This report's out about a week later than I would normally like to have it, but this month I've included two additional sections in the report. One, I'm looking at the building consent numbers from across all of New Zealand, just to give us a bit of a benchmark as to what's happening around the rest of the country. And last Thursday, Stats New Zealand released its annual population numbers update. And so I really wanted to take a couple of days to have a look at that data in detail and then compare it to the number of dwellings that we're building here in Canterbury, and just sort of include that in the report as well. So there's lots of information in this month's report and plenty to get through. So what I've done is I have put together a PowerPoint presentation with some slides. I think it might be a little bit easier to follow along with some of the numbers, and we'll see how we go. So four things I want to cover off in this video this month. Obviously looking at the building consent numbers, and I will break that down into what's going on in Christchurch, Selwyn and Waimak. The data from, I get data from about a dozen councils across New Zealand, but I also get the data from Stats New Zealand. Whilst the data from the councils contains a lot more detail than the information that I get out of Stats NZ, it's really good to follow or track all regions and territorial authorities across New Zealand, just because it gives a really good benchmark, a really good idea as to what's happening across the rest of the country, and that way we can compare what's happening here in Canterbury. Obviously, I mentioned before about the population data that's just come out of Stats NZ, and such an important metric to understand and to follow with the importance to how many houses we build. So I'm going to talk a little bit about that in detail. And then finally, I want to very briefly, I want to cover what's happened just in the last month or so with the Christchurch City Council and them basically rejecting the government's medium density proposals going forward. And of course, again, that has a significant bearing on where and how many houses we build. So I'm going to talk a little bit about that. So look, let's get into it now. So in September, there were 575 new residential dwellings consented across all three councils. So that's a 6% decline in the number of dwellings compared to September of last year. Now that's only the third time this year that we've actually seen an overall decrease in the number of dwellings consented. You can see from this graph here, building consent numbers are starting to slow. You can see from that red trend line that is starting to ease off slightly. There's still plenty of ups and downs in the market, but that line I think will continue to flatten off over the next 6 to 12 months to come. So in Christchurch, there were 365 dwellings consented, 160 in Selwyn, and just 50 in Waimak. Apart from the fact that there was the same number in Selwyn as last year, you can see obviously a significant drop in both Waimak and to a lesser extent in Christchurch. But again, given how strong the new building consent numbers in Christchurch have been over the last 12 months, a decline stands out quite noticeably. So here's what's happening with each of the three councils. And again, certainly in Christchurch, there's a lot of fluctuations with regard to numbers coming through. Two reasons for this. One, the Christchurch City Council has been and still is behind in processing of its building consent applications. And three times this year, they've popped out a number in excess of 500, which is quite unusual. So, but also at the same time, usually in those larger months, we see those higher density medium density dwellings coming through as well. But when you look at what's going on across the last 12 months, so Christchurch overall is up by 33%. So that's 33% more dwellings than were consented for the same 12-month period in 2021, whilst Selwyn is down by 6% and Wymap is down by 5%. And that's going to have, just remember those numbers, because that's going to have some bearing when I talk about population growth or decline in a few slides time. So year to date, so the 12 months to September, 7,000 new residential dwellings. So that's up 16% year on year. And as we saw from the slide before, that's pretty much almost solely down to the number of multi-unit dwellings that are continuing to be consented here in Christchurch. Cost of construction, so the consented value of dwellings are $224 million for September. That's up 8% on September last year. That line, again, is starting to flatten off, not quite as quickly as the line in the number of building consents, but obviously the increase in consented value is directly and solely related to the increase in the cost of building materials that everyone's had to sort of put up with. It. So really, it's a tough time to be in the construction industry at the moment. Year to date, $2.5 billion, and that's up 26%. And again, you can point the finger directly at the cost increases that have been occurred in building materials. Multi-unit dwellings. So in September, there were 205 dwellings consented, and that was across 42 building consent applications. So that's an average of about five dwellings per project. This is down again, sort of in the last 3 or 4 months, we've seen some really big projects sort of come through for a number of the key developers in Christchurch. But if we look at what's going on in Selwyn and Wymap, there's virtually no multi-unit construction whatsoever, and certainly nothing like what we're seeing in Christchurch. In fact, the four units that were consented in Selwyn, one was a house in an investment package, so there was a family house with an attached separate rental flat, so two dwellings there, and the second application was for a large family home and a secondary dwelling, second house on that site as well. So again, there's absolutely no demand for medium density construction in either Selwyn or Wymap. Now, just remember that, because I'm going to come back to that a little bit later on when I talk about the Christchurch City Council and the government with regard to medium density development. I mentioned that I also track the building consent numbers from Stats NZ across all of New Zealand. So in August, and their numbers are 1 month behind the data that I get from the council and process it. So in August, there were 4,500 residential dwellings consented across the whole of New Zealand. And that was a 1% increase on August of 2021. But look, get this, year to date, so the 12 months to the end of August, 50,600 residential dwellings consented, and that's up 9%. So those are just staggering numbers, continuing the increase across the whole of the country. But if we look at what's going on individually in some of the regions, we see that Auckland's down by 13%, Wellington's down by 8%, and I believe that over the coming 6 to 12 months, I think that we'll see a trend of red across that particular graph there. But before we move on to talking about population data, the information that's just come out from Stats NZ, I want to talk just very, very briefly about why we build houses. Now that may seem like a silly question, especially to the audience who's watching this video, but just bear with me, because it's why we build houses has a significant bearing on the number of houses that we build and the type of houses we build and where we build them. So I've talked about this on a number of occasions. If you've ever been to a presentation, I normally sort of delve into this a little bit. So I'm going to go over this very, very quickly, because I'm sure you'll get the gist of what I'm trying to say. So there's three main reasons as to why we build houses. Firstly, population growth. Here in New Zealand, traditionally, we have had a growing and increasing population. And of course, therefore, we need more houses to accommodate that level of population. Obsolescence. So that's knocking down old shitty houses and replacing them with warm, dry, healthy new ones. And then, of course, you've got the changing demographics. So the makeup of our household structure. So we are having smaller families. We're having families later. We are an aging population. So therefore, that long-term trend is towards smaller dwellings. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to unpack each of these things, and I'm going to talk about specifically how they relate to construction in the current market. So changing demographics. So yes, obviously our families are getting smaller. We're having families later. And of course, I mentioned before that certainly the increase in the number of retirement villages that are being built across the country. So that has a long-term effect of smaller households. So we measure that in persons per household. So currently here in Canterbury, we've got an average of 2.7 persons per household, and that's predicted to decrease to about 2.45 persons per household over the next 30 years. So whilst that's a definite trend, it's a very long-term trend, and yes, if you've got 100,000 or 150,000 houses in a region, any decrease in the average household occupancy will mean that we may need more houses, but that's a very long-term trend. Look, it's a little bit like obsolescence. Pretty much all the old shitty houses here in Canterbury have already been knocked down in the earthquakes and replaced with some lovely new ones. Look, we are still seeing a level of older houses, certainly here in Christchurch and some of those outer suburbs of Avonhead or Rusley or some of those outlying areas where we're sitting on an old house on a large section and a family wants to build a new house on this. So we're still seeing some of that, but that's only a very small percentage of what's being built here in Canterbury. Well, certainly in Selwyn and Waimak, there's almost no older houses being knocked down. Those new subdivisions, those areas are still largely too new, with lots of new greenfield subdivision. So there's almost no older houses being knocked down, which of course brings me to population growth. Now I've got some slides that'll talk specifically about what's happening with population growth in a minute. But obviously, it is the number one key driver for housing growth here in New Zealand. And so it's really important that we understand and take into account the changes in population. And of course, unfortunately, the best measure we get for population is census, which is once every 5 years, unless you have an earthquake. So the data that's coming out of Stats NZ on an annual basis for expected population change, this isn't an absolute fact, you know, 100% accurate number, but it's pretty good, and it's a really good guide to let us look at the number of houses that we're building and to sort of see how that's tracking against population and what the potential demand might be. So this graph here, this looks at the number of people, what we call international migration. So net international migration is measured as the number of people who are arriving in New Zealand less the number of people who are leaving. And currently, and certainly since early 2021, we've been in a situation where there have been more people leaving New Zealand than arriving. And look, compare that to literally 12 months ago from when the COVID lockdown happened, we were bringing, there was a net increase in the people coming into New Zealand of almost 90,000 people. And so that's a massive turn off of the tap of people coming in, tens of thousands of people a year less coming into New Zealand. And of course, that directly relates to the need for the number of new houses that we're building. Now this graph here, look, unfortunately, these tables, perhaps a little bit complicated. So just jump straight to the right-hand column there, the coloured columns. And this is the change in population for Christchurch, Selwyn and Waimak across the last 12 months. And what we see here is that Christchurch has lost 700 people. Now, that's not a massive number when you expect that, when you look at Christchurch has a population of about 400,000. So that's really only about a 0.2% loss. But it's still a loss, especially when Selwyn has grown by 3,600, and that was that's a 5% growth on their population, and Waimak has increased by 1,400 people, and that's a 2% increase in their population. But look, if we look at 2021, which is the table at the bottom, again we see a net loss of people from Christchurch. That increase again in Selwyn and Waimak. So what's actually driving population changes? Because if there isn't anyone coming into the country, in fact, we're losing people, how do these population changes occur? Well, principally, it's people moving from one part of New Zealand to another. And we've certainly seen over the last 12 months or so, this what they call the southern drift. So people in Auckland or in the North Island selling up and moving southwards, particularly to Selwyn and to Waimak, because proportionately house prices and land prices and the cost of living is cheaper. But look at that that 2,700 loss of population in Christchurch. I bet you that a whole bunch of those people that have left the city have probably moved to either Lincoln or Wollaston. But look, let's look at those numbers now against the number of houses or the number of dwellings that have been consented in that same 12-month period. So population growth of 3,600 for Selwyn, and we see about 1,800 new houses built. So yeah, that's not a too bad household occupancy number. We can certainly see that those numbers make sense. And same thing when we look at Waimak. A population increase of 1,300 and we built or consented 830 new dwellings. But look, compare that to Christchurch. We had a population loss of 700 people and we consented more than 4,000 new dwellings. Now, I know there's a lag between the market, when the market changes and when the construction industry catches up with those changes. But look, that's an awful lot of dwellings to be building. And again, bear in mind that over the last 12 months, 60% of all those dwellings that have been consented in Christchurch have been part of a multi-unit dwelling, a multi-unit development. So just think about that for a second. Look, I want to jump on now to this medium density stuff, because that follows on directly from what we were just talking about how many of these blocks of apartments that are being built around the place. So the government has produced a series of national policy statements aimed at increasing the number of, making it easier to build more houses across New Zealand. And so that's the national policy statement on urban development. And one of the key things in that particular policy was that you wouldn't need a resource consent to build three dwellings of up to three stories on any section anywhere in New Zealand, regardless of the zoning. And in principle, that might seem like a good idea and free things up. And there's been a lot of talk about the Resource Consent Act and how it slows things down and adds red tape. But if you look at what's going on here in Christchurch, and I come back to what I said a few slides ago before about what's happening in Selwyn and Waimak. So here in Christchurch, last month in August, 74% of all new residential dwellings consented in the city were part of a multi-unit project. So really, Christchurch doesn't really need this. I know that council staff just seem hell-bent on driving everyone to live in the central city with apartments and certainly in that inner fringe suburbs. But the reality is, if you look at the population growth in Selwyn and the type of construction that's going on in Selwyn, we've equally got to focus on individual standalone family houses with a backyard. Look, for the last 12 months, the Christchurch City Council has been actively objecting to pretty much every plan change request for a new subdivision in Selwyn. And the reason for that is because they want to drive this multi-unit construction in the central city. They want to drive residency occupancy into the central city and certainly the city fringe suburbs. But by the council voting this down, it really sends a signal to me that the council doesn't really know what it wants or certainly what it needs with regard to this type of construction. On one hand, we're ignoring the fact that Selwyn and Waimakariri are growing at a much faster rate than Christchurch with regard to the number of dwellings being consented and also the type of dwelling. So look, maybe into the future, I think that the market will certainly change and there we'll see a much greater take up of residency in these apartments. But for the short to medium term, I think that there still needs to be a focus on greenfield residential subdivision development, and certainly Selwyn and to a lesser extent Waimak are the favoured options by the people who are choosing to move into this region. But look, obviously that's a much broader subject. I've been asked by the media on a number of occasions over the last couple of weeks, do I think that the government will put a commissioner into the council and just make them do this? I think that the government has enough problems on its plate at the moment. And it seems like a reasonable request to come up with a bespoke solution, because certainly we don't need this level of programs in the city, because we're certainly building plenty of houses at the moment. But the interesting thing is that this plan change has been adopted by both Selwyn and Waimak, and yet there is no demand for that type of construction out there. So I think we really need to have another look at the whole region, and I know that the Greater Christchurch Partnership has looked at it, and but look, it's something that needs to be continually tweaked, because as we've just seen, the population change in the economy, the number of houses we build does change on a regular basis, and so this data that we're looking at here is a really important key part of that. So look, I think that's a really good place to wrap it up right now. So just I want to give a quick summary as to what we've talked about so far. So overall, building consent numbers are starting to soften. There are still some extraordinarily high numbers coming through, but overall that trend is starting to flatten out. Of course, the cost of construction, the consented value, that is still continuing to go up. I hope that we've seen the worst of it, but obviously the construction industry, like the rest of New Zealand, is at the mercy of the overall inflation in the country, and of course that is likely to set to see the cost of construction materials continue to rise over the next 12 to 18 months. The multi-unit market is clearly oversupplied. I think I've demonstrated that quite clearly with the numbers. And I think what we will see is that over the coming 12 to 18 months, I think a lot of the projects that have been planned will be delayed or possibly shelved indefinitely as that market just corrects itself. Of course, just to sort of make matters worse, is that we've got negative net migration in the country, and that doesn't just mean less people, which means less houses. What it also means is that the people who are actually leaving the country at the moment are builders and plumbers and sparkies and tradies in general, and nurses and doctors and teachers, and the people that this country really just can't afford to lose. So that's just going to make things tougher again. On the plus side, Canterbury, Selwyn and Waimak seems to be a place of choice to move to for a lot of people from the rest of the country. And I think that will continue to to grow over the coming years. I think that that will be a long term trend, that these places will be popular. Look, Amberley is another good example of a really close neighbour that is growing really, really well. Of course, all this comes on 2 years of population decreases for Christchurch. So I think Christchurch needs to have a bit of a look at itself with regard to what it's building, what it's delivering to the market, and possibly what that market actually wants in the way of housing. I'm not going to talk about the economic squeeze. I think everyone is familiar enough with that. I encourage you to read Tony Alexander. He's he often has some really bright points with regard to the economy, where many others are doom and gloom. But that's not an easy thing for anyone at the moment, which, of course, I believe that we will continue to see a softening in the housing market in New Zealand. I think we'll see a lot more regions and territorial authorities showing red with regard to the number of building consents being issued. So look, that's my summary for what's going on in the construction industry for September. Thank you for staying to the end. If you like the data that you've seen in this video here, I would encourage you to subscribe to my monthly report. This is only a fraction of the data that I analyse in the report in itself, but in addition to the report, the printer, the PDF report, you get a couple of Excel spreadsheets. The first spreadsheet lists every single residential building consent that's been issued by Christchurch, Selwyn and Wimac for that particular month. I also do a lot of other analysis on the cost of construction and the size of construction and where we're building and who's building what. And then of course, the second spreadsheet is a list of all applicants across all three councils, and that's for the last 12 months. So again, it's very, very easy to see who's building how many across the region. So look, thank you very much for watching this video. Look, if you've got any questions or comments, please email me or comment on this channel or whatever. I don't have all the answers, and I really enjoy talking about the industry with other people, with other professionals, just to sort of get a slightly different insight as to what's going on in the market. So again, thank you very much for watching this video, and feel free to reach out with any questions. Back next month. Thank you.